Hello, hello, folks. My name is Fred Jordan. I'm a professor at Curtin University, and I'm also the director of the Argonne-Argonne Lab. Now, today what I want to talk about is the volcanism on an asteroid, and especially asteroid Vesta. Now, if you look at the planet and asteroid, some of them sustain volcanism, but we don't really know when this volcanism stopped. When was the last eruption? Right? And it's a bit intuitive, but the bigger the body is, the longer it's going to sustain volcanism. So here, what I want to do is to go straight to the tiniest of them all, Vesta. And because if it's small, it's easy to understand. It's less complex. There's no plate tectonics and things like that, like on Earth. Now, before jumping on Vesta, I want to talk about the technique I'm going to use. I'm going to use, the technique based on the decay of potassium to argon. So it's a dating technique. It's a radioisotope. But the one I'm using is argon-argon. It's the same except we transform the potassium into argon-39 in the core of a nuclear reactor that allows us to measure those isotopes on the same instrument. And because of that, it's a much more efficient technique. Now, the lab is based at Curtin University. It's part of the John DeLater Center, and it's also supported by OSCOP. I'm the lab director since 2007, and there's a few staff that help me in my endeavor, and we equip with the best equipment that is available. I mean, that allows us to push the boundary, and especially in planetary science. Now, let's go back to Vesta. I mentioned this is really a tiny asteroid. So how tiny is that? Tiny like that. That's not Vesta, that's Ceres. Vesta is supposed to be round as well, or spherical, but has been beheaded by a giant impact. Now, Vesta is part of the asteroid belt, and it's very special. It's a volcanic asteroid, if you want. When it agglomerates, it differentiates in a core, mantle, and a crust. And the crust is entirely basaltic. So the argon-argon technique that I mentioned before, it's really good to study basalt, right? And you can do two things in space with argon-argon, especially. You can do dating volcanic activity, volcanic event, or cooling of volcanic event, or you can date impact. Now, the thing is, you can't do date both on the same rock. If you have an impact, it's going to mess the isotopic clock and reset that. So either your rock is pristine and you can date volcanic activity if you get a basalt, or it's been reset or partially reset by an impact. In this case, we want to focus on rocks that are called unbrecciated, which means they have not been shocked. And therefore, they record the volcanic history on an asteroid. Really, what I want to do here is to answer this question. How long did Vesta stay volcanically active, right? There's a bunch of spin-off question, if you want, as well, associated with all that. But here today, really, when is the last eruption? Now, there's a bunch of different rocks like metamorphic granulite, gabbros, pyroxenite, but those ones, they really address the cooling. So the best rock for that is a basalt. So we find one. There's not that many. Most of the rock are kind of gabbroic, actually, but we find one. And this one is very fine grain. So we did a bit of SEM on it. You can see here it's made of pyroxene and plagioclase. But it was not, to our dismay at first, it was not truly unbrecciated. Because you get nice igneous clast here, but you also have some vein. And those vein, they're likely to be caused by impact that melt the rock, the adjacent rock, and the melt infiltrate and percolate through igneous basement. That was one limitation here. So was this part shocked by the impact? And that all the complete key. If it's too shocked, then either you did an impact or something in between the age of eruption and impact. So we did some EBSD. So I'm not a specialist of EBSD. I asked my colleague Lucy. She's very good at that. Well, can you have a look at this rock and let's see if it's shock or not. And what was really interesting, what came out of that is the EBSD image of it. And it really showed that some parts were shocked. So how do we know that? This is the map of misorientation. The more color you have, the more shock it is, because the plan of the crystal have moved around, if you want. So yeah, the more color, the more shock. So obviously here you get a bit of shock, here you get no shock, here you get very little, it's almost nothing, right? So what happened is this vein, which is unshocked because it was associated with the shock, infiltrating between, but the shock wave really didn't change this so much. So the story of this rock is something like that. You get the crystallization of a very shallow intrusive rock or a lava flow, actually. And later on, you get an impact nearby. You get cracks in this rock, the volcanic rock, and the impact melt infiltrate in this crack, and they quench very rapidly. So really the question was, well, was that affected by the impact? And that changed everything. If you want to date the lava and it's affected by shock, then either you date the shock or something in between. So we analyzed those clasts, and we analyzed the melt vein, and we get some really, really nice age. So the clasts, they all give the same age, okay? That's all the age that are right here. So we did several aliquots. I'm not going to go into detail, but those age spectrum, as we call them, they really tell us that the system hasn't been perturbed, or almost not perturbed. Not perturbed at all, or almost not perturbed in this case. This one, it really indicates a bit of perturbation, but that one was the melt rock vein itself. So in terms of the clast, yes, we dated the clast and we get this age right here in bold and big, 45, 31 million plus minus 6 million. And that's really a robust age. But like I mentioned before, one of the issue for us is really like, is that the Ignis age or it could have been reset? So we did a bunch of modeling, and I'm not going to torture you talking too much about that, because this is probably way beyond your what you're working on. But those models, what they tell us is that, no, the argon system wouldn't be affected by such a small impact or the heating of the vein. So that was really good news for us. This is really a magmatic age that we have. So we really dated the lava flow. Now what's important is really to compare with what we have, because if you get one lava flow, then that's interesting, but you know, well, what does that really mean? So we compare with all of the previous result that we have. And some of them are about crystal cooling, some of them about the early activity on the asteroid. I'm not going to go into detail, but a few of them, like this one or this one, they are ignis. So forget this graph. Let's move to the other one. I'm going to move that. That is the one that really where ignis age have been dated. That's the new one we just dropped here. That's some that we published last year. And that is based on zircon dating and that as well. So you can see they're all aligned around this age of 45, 30. And that's the youngest we have, actually, right? So it's not because we didn't find it that didn't exist, but so far, everything we analyze on those samples, the youngest ignis age is around 45, 30. Now we had a bonus with that, which was interesting, is like some model of ESTA predict that the magnetic field of the core is going to extinguish in 5-10 million years. But here this rock recorded the magnetic field, which was active 35 million years after accretion. So really, it challenged a bit a few models here, but like I said, this is not the only rock. Now it started to be part of a collection of rock that really indicate that Vesta was still active at this time. Maybe that was not the last eruption, but that's the one we sure of. Sorry, there you go. So this cartoon could have said that it's been drawn by my 5-year-old son, and you know, but it's been drawn by me. So my artistic skill, they are not really up there, but that's okay. I'll take that. At least this is informative. So that's a bunch of rock we dated with argon, and uranium lead as well for this one. And they really start to see show the story of the crust of Vesta. And this one is right here at the very surface or very near surface. And that's the last eruption here. I think that's it for this time. Yeah, there you go. Hope you enjoy. And if you have any question, well, I guess we'll do that live. See you later, folks.